Do we have to pay? Hey guys, it's Tom and welcome to today's travel vlog. I'm here in Dusseldorf, Germany. And I've been here a few times already before, but still I didn't want to waste the sunny weather that's here in Dusseldorf. It's springtime now in Germany. And I thought, hey, this is an amazing opportunity to go to another city that's near Dusseldorf and learn more about its history and culture. So I chose Cologne. Cologne is actually only a 30 to 45 minute train ride from Dusseldorf. So super, super convenient since I've only got the afternoon. So what we're going to do is try and make the most of the afternoon in Cologne, learn about its history, things to do there, sights to see, and of course you all know that we're going to try and find some yummy German food to eat along the way too. So let's get on that train and learn all about Cologne today. I'm here at Dusseldorf Airport train station and I'm here with a friend, so we got our tickets to get to Cologne. It works out cheaper if you get a group ticket, so make sure you do that if you're traveling with another person or with a group of people. Don't get your tickets at the ticket machine. Go to the main area where you buy tickets with a member of staff, because they're going to end up getting a cheaper ticket for you. It costs €37.20, so for both of us it costs about 18 to 19 euro each return ticket. It also works out cheap if you get a return ticket on the same day from Dusseldorf to Cologne and back. So that's the tip there for you. The trains are about every 20 minutes to Cologne and back, and it's gonna take about 45 minutes to get there. So we're just waiting for our train. It should be here any minute now, and let's get ourselves to Cologne. Welcome to Cologne. I've just arrived here. I just got off the train and the main train station here in Cologne, just a few steps away, you're greeted by Cologne Cathedral, which is just behind me. It looks absolutely beautiful. The sun glistening on it. It's sunset coming up in the next hour or so. So we came at just the right time. Now, Cologne Cathedral actually attracts about 20,000 visitors per day, and it's the most visited landmark here in Germany, so that's pretty cool, don't you think? And in 1880, it was actually the world's tallest building at just over 157 meters tall, so it's Gothic-inspired architecture. Let's go inside and have a look at the Cologne Cathedral. So it's time for a little bit of a snack, and I found something that is very local and traditional here in Cologne, and it's a Nougat Brezel. So it's basically like a pretzel covered in kind of like roasted almonds, and it smells amazing. Everyone's been buying it here. It's really, really popular here, so let's give it a try. It tastes so good. It's got a hint of Nutella in it, like hazelnut chocolate, in this pretzel. Super, super yum. I suggest you have to try this when you're in Cologne, because it's only from here that you can get this Nougat pretzel. So we've got to finish this now. So I'm now here in Hohenzollern Bridge here in Cologne. It's one of the main bridges to cross the Rhine River here in Cologne. Now, as you can see, there's a lot of really, really cool padlocks behind me. There's actually a really cool tradition here. So if you come with your loved one here in Cologne, head down to Hohenzollern Bridge, buy a padlock, connect it to the bridge, and throw the key together into the Rhine River, and that's supposed to signify everlasting love. So sweet, right? So we're gonna take a closer look at Hohenzollern Bridge. Sorry for my pronunciation, I'm so bad. I'm trying my best, but let's take a closer look at Hohenzollern Bridge. And as you can see, there's so many people down here, so let's take a closer look before the sun sets. Across from the Rhine River, so we wanted to get something a little bit local, have something local to drink too, just so I can show you guys. So we've just taken our orders, so I can't wait to show you guys what we've got. So the drink that I ordered is a Früh Kölsch. It's a local beer. It's special to be here in Cologne, so I was really curious to try it. It's kind of small because I just wanted to taste it. It smells super light, so let's see. Super, super yum. That's why I love German beer sometimes. Sometimes beer is really, really heavy. But the beers in Germany, I love them because they're super light. They go down really, really well, and they don't make you feel heavy after. So when in Cologne, try the Früh Kölsch. So here's what I've ordered, something very local. It's the Rheinische Sauerbraten, if I pronounce that correctly. So it's basically a beef marinated in vinegar and wine, and it comes with red cabbage, sauerkraut, and potato dumplings. It looks absolutely yummy and delicious. It's a huge portion, so we decided to share it. It's 17 euros for this, so let's see how it is. This dish is absolutely beautiful. The marinated vinegar and the wine that the beef's been marinated in actually goes really, really well together with the applesauce. And it's perfect with the Kölsch beer that we got here. So when you're in Cologne, make sure you try this dish and always match it with the local Cologne specialty beer, Kölsch beer. So let's finish dinner. I'm in the train station now, guys, here in Cologne, about to catch my train back to Dusseldorf. So I spent a good 3 to 4 hours here in the afternoon, and I'm really, really happy I came down to learn a bit more about Cologne and tick another city off of my Germany list of places I wanted to go to. Cologne is amazing, especially if you're flying into Dusseldorf and wanna go somewhere nearby that isn't too far. It's a quick 30-40 minute train ride from Dusseldorf. But I really liked checking out the Cologne Cathedral. It's free to get in, so that's pretty amazing. A lot of churches around the world, especially landmarks, you've got to pay to get in. But Cologne Cathedral, it's free entry, so you can go inside and really spend a lot of time taking in the whole Gothic architecture of the cathedral. It was really, really nice to check out the bridge and all the padlocks there. That was really, really cool. And I was so happy I was able to try the Nougat Brezel and some local Cologne cuisine at the local bar and restaurant that I checked out. And the Kölsch beer. There you have it, guys. I hope you liked today's travel vlog. Short and sweet, but I like to keep it this way. Cologne, definitely check it out if you do have some extra time in Germany. If you haven't checked out my channel yet, do so. There might be some other destinations and cities or countries that you are heading to, and I might be able to give you some good travel advice there. If you do like this video, do give it a like. It's really gonna help out my channel. And I hope to see you in my next travel vlog. I've got a few more up my sleeve for next month, so I'll see you all then.